Hello and welcome. Today we'll be going over the various functions of the buttons and knobs on the MOHR CT100 TDR. This is put together as a sort of beginner or refresher course so that you can know exactly what each of the buttons do. Here's the back of the CT100. You can see you have your DC power input, your Ethernet cable, your USB port, and your power switch. That's the off position, that's the on position. First, reach around behind and turn on the main power switch, and then push this red button to turn it on. The red button's the power button. As you can obviously see, it's now booting up. Now, the first thing we're going to go over are these four buttons here and this one. These are the cursor, scaling, and position knobs. The first one we're going to look at is the cursor button. This allows you to change cursors. There's two cursors on this machine. One is indicated by a solid red line as the active cursor. One is indicated by a dashed red line as an inactive cursor. Let's go ahead and make this one active. This knob changes the position of the active cursor. You can move it left, you can move it right, and once you reach the end of the screen, it'll keep on scrolling the screen. It's a good way to get things in view. You can move it any way you want. To change cursors, simply press this button and then move this cursor around. This is horizontal scale. It allows you to zoom in horizontally and zoom out horizontally. By increasing the horizontal scale, you can get much closer to precise cursor positions. There, it's at 0 feet. Now, this is vertical scale. By changing vertical scale, you zoom in on that portion of the trace. Now, this is best utilized with this position knob, which is this one right here. It allows you to change the position of the trace so that when you do use vertical scale, not everything goes off the screen. This allows you to have very precise measurements of where you're looking. The next ones we're going to go into are the menu buttons, and there's three menu buttons. One here, your main menu button. One here, your scan menu button. And one here, your library menu button. The main menu button allows you to access many things and is also your back button. Press it once to open up the menu and once again to close. The scan menu button lets you open up the scan menu, obviously, which allows you to save traces, add, hide, scan, custom, maths, all sorts of things. Press the main menu button and then again to close. The library button allows you to add custom cable types, load custom cable types, and other such things, and we'll get into that in a later video. Now, each of these four buttons on the vertically and four buttons horizontally correspond to their selections in the menu. So for example, this one changes cable length right now. This one would go to display and power settings. This one would go to math. Let's close that out. Finally, this is the multi-function knob, and this is the multi-function button. You can change the function of the multi-function knob by pressing the multi-function button, and by turning the knob, you will change the value. Finally, I want to talk about auto-fit. Autofit's a very useful button and displays the entire trace on the screen when you press it. So for example, right now it'll display the trace right here, this little bump right there, if I press the autofit button. There, and you can see, scale the horizontal position back, and we're right back to where we were. AutoFit can be a very useful tool. Let's say you've lost exactly where your cursor is and you don't know how to find it again. Press AutoFit once and there it is. Sometimes you'll have to press it a second time to get back exactly to where you want to be. And the nice thing is it'll AutoFit whatever is plugged into your cable. So it'll auto-fit the entire trace on the screen. Another thing you can do with auto-fit is press and hold the button for 2 seconds, and then both cursors will appear at the start and the end of the trace. And that's very useful for when you want to find the start and the end of the trace, or you need to find your cursors. All right, so that's about it for the buttons and knobs. I hope this video was educational for you, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye-bye.